words. Such was the case with Pharaoh's people and those before them. They denied their Lord's signs, so we destroyed them for their wrong actions. We drowned Pharaoh's people. All of them were wrongdoers. When Pharaoh realized that he was about to die, he said he believed in God and asked him to save him. But this last-minute repentance was of no use. This is because God forgives our mistakes only if we're sincerely sorry for what we have done. God is very forgiving, but the repentance a person feels the moment he realizes he is about to die is not sincere, and so may be of no use. This was the case with Pharaoh. This being the case, here is something we should not forget. We must live our lives in a way that will please God and not fall into Pharaoh's error. If we do not live our lives according to the high moral teachings of the Quran and do not obey its commands, it may do us no good if we repent at the hour of death. Prophet Muhammad. The last prophet sent by God to mankind was Prophet Muhammad. May God bless him and grant him peace. The last holy book is the Quran. Ill-intentioned people changed the book sent before the Quran. Therefore, their originals, the true revelations that were sent to the people, did not survive to our day. But God sent us the Quran, the book He stated cannot be changed. Our Lord tells us in the Quran that He will protect it. It is we who have sent down the reminder, and we who will preserve it. The word "we" in this verse refers to God. There is no other deity but God. He has no partner or helper. With His all-sufficient power and His infinite knowledge and might, He is the only God. The last prophet, Muhammad, lived about 1400 years ago. For this reason, we have some information about him. Our prophet delivered the truths revealed by God in the Quran to the society he lived in. He called them to worship God and pray to him. He told them that they had to give thanks to God for the countless blessings he gives them. He said they had to obey him if they wanted to be happy in the life after death, in the world to come. But some arrogant, ill-intentioned people in that society did not obey his call. They tried to make things difficult for him and forced him to leave Mecca, where he had been born and brought up. God did not let these ill-intentioned people destroy the religion of Islam, and it has come down to us unchanged. our Prophet moved from Mecca to Medina, where some Muslim friends believed and helped him. The appeal of the Prophet is valid also for all people living today. Those who fear God and desire forgiveness for their sins must obey Him. Say, if you love God, then follow me, and God will love you and forgive you for your wrong actions. God is ever forgiving, most merciful. So kids, if we want God to love us, we have to do what our Prophet has told us, and do it as well as we can. Conclusion. Dear friends, in this film we have come to know only a few of the prophets that God has sent down to mankind. All the prophets that have been sent through history called their societies to worship God. In performing their duty, they did not want any recompense from the people they spoke to. These individuals had nothing to gain from delivering God's message to their societies. They did their duty only because God entrusted them with it. They loved Him, and they wanted Him to love them. What the prophets have said also applies to us. We should read the Quran and take an example from the lives of the prophets. In this way, we will have a life of happiness in the hereafter. You still may be young, but don't forget that one day you will be old and people will call you sir and ma'am. There may be some who say that it is too early for you to think about death. But don't forget that no one knows the time when God will take them. You may die in one day or in 10 years. When you think of these things, you realize how important it is to waste no time in becoming the person God wants you to be. For this reason, you shouldn't waste time. Think about all these truths and start to be the kind of person that God loves.